There are multiple reasons why I'm privileged to be here, but I want to highlight at the outset two of them. First of all, I grew up in a UCC church. Joining faith with action is the modern witness. And it calls us to search for social justice. Everett Parker took that challenge to the parochial corners of telecommunications policy. And that's what we celebrate today. Secondly, I knew Everett Parker. Not well, but I knew your dad. Not well, but in the late 70s, we both advocated for diversity of voices in the media. I was doing it for the cable television industry, which had an obvious interest in overcoming the restrictive rules of the FCC. And Everett Parker was doing it because diversity of choice and diversity of opportunity was what he was all about. Today we celebrate Reverend Everett Parker's service to God and his contributions to society. As was explained, when he appealed the FCC's 1965 decision to grant WLBT's license renewal in United Church of Christ v. FCC, he not only took on racism, but he also established a landmark precedent that gave ordinary citizens the right for the first time to participate in FCC proceedings. And the fact that today all FCC processes are open and that anyone can provide comments on the topics we discuss is a tremendous legacy that we all too often take for granted. Everett Parker was motivated by a dream that the principal means of communications in this country should serve everybody, regardless of the color of their skin or the size of their paycheck. His work continues today. And it's in that spirit that I'm proud to be here with you this morning and to receive this recognition. Thank you very much.